Okay, hello everyone. So let's see functional electrical stimulator. So this topic comes in unit 3. So let's see what is the definition for functional electrical stimulator, which the short form is FES. FES is a device that is used to provide electrical currents to activate the nerves affected by conditions such as paralysis resulting from the spinal cord injury or head injury or stroke and other neurological disorders. Now the paralysis means the complete or the partial loss of muscle function. So those who are having the with paralysis, their nerve will be affected. So what is the FES devices does is that they are trying to provide the electrical pulse or the electrical current to the affected nerve area so as to restore the function of the affected nerves. Okay. Now, FES is a rehabilitative technique that is primarily employed to restore the function in people troubled with certain disabilities. It helps in strengthening muscles and can significantly improve a person's ability to carry out functional activities such as walking or using their limbs. It is also sometimes referred to as neuromuscular electrical stimulation, that is NMES. Now let's see what is the principle behind this FES. So it is based on the electrophysiological phenomena that involves the study of the production of electrical activity and the effects of that electrical activity on the body. So let's consider that when you're trying to pick up the EMG signal, that is EMG signal is generated when the muscle is getting contracted and relaxed. Okay, so that time you are able to pick up the EMG signal. Now, what is actually happening when the muscle is getting contracted and why you are getting a signal? And that gives an idea about the principle behind your FES system. Okay, let's see that. So a normal muscular contraction results in the migration of ions, which generates potential difference that can be measured with suitably placed electrodes. So when the muscle is getting contracted, and if I am placing a surface electrodes over the area in which the muscle is getting contracted, I am able to pick up a potential difference signal. Why I am able to pick up the potential difference signal? Because of the migration of ions, the signal is getting generated. Now the same thing if you apply backward, that is, I am going to use an external electrical pulse to the affected muscle region. So I'm using an external electrical, since this is possible, means the other thing also we can try. It is possible. That is, we are using the external electrical pulse to the affected muscle area in order to restore the function of the affected muscle. Okay, so that forms the basis for your FES system. Okay, so as this activity of the living tissue is a result of the potential changes in them, it leads to the inevitable conclusion that the external electricity can be used for the diagnosis of certain diseases affecting muscles and nerves, for the augmentation or replacement of a deficient natural activity, or for the restoration of a pulsed muscle. So that is the affected with paralysis. Okay, so this is the affected with paralysis condition. So the external electrical pulses can be applied to the area in which the muscle is affected so as to restore the function of the affected muscle. Okay, so in short, I can say that FES utilizes the electrical pulse to stimulate the neural tissue with the objective of restoring or enhancing a lost or diminished nerve function. I will repeat. So FES utilizes the electrical pulse to stimulate the neural tissue with the objective of restoring or enhancing a lost or a diminished nerve function. So the electrical pulses produce, the electrical pulses which I am going to apply produces the contraction in the paralyzed muscle by electrically stimulating the nerves. Okay, so the electrical pulses produce the contraction in paralyzed muscle by electrically stimulating the nerves. So which is the basis of your FES system? Now the FES devices take advantage of this property to electrically activate the nerve cells, which then may go on to activate muscles and other nerves. So now let's see with an example how the FES does the job for a particular condition. So before taking into an example, we'll see what is inside the FES system. So when you see what is inside in the FES system, the example will be very easy to understand. So first, let's see what is inside in the FES system. So a typical typical FES system that is shown in this figure, that is, it is placed in the leg region. So this modern FES units are portable device which consists of a control box. So this is your control box, about the size of a pack of cards, which is worn either on your leg or around your waist also it will be placed. So the control box is a self-contained device with low power consumption, small size and lightweight, and that is user friendly also. Now let's see what is there in this entire unit. What is the basic block diagram? So the basic block diagram of your FES unit is that you will be having a sensor unit followed by an electrical stimulator followed by electrodes. Then the signal is given to the patient. So here this electrical stimulator is a pulse generator. It's actually a pulse generator which will be generating the train of electrical pulse. So now the pulse generator, so this electrical stimulator or the pulse generator receives the signal, the command signals from the sensor, and the electrical stimulator or the pulse generator generates the train of electrical pulse and delivers those to the excitable tissues through electrodes. And this electrode can be of two kinds, surface electrodes or subcutaneous electrodes. So it can be of two types, surface electrodes or subcutaneous electrodes. So this is what I have said. Now the pulse generator receives the command signal from the sensor and generates a train of electric pulse and delivers those to the excitable tissues via electrodes. And the command signal is issued by the sensor for selecting the mode of activity, and the electrodes can either be surface electrodes or subcutaneous electrodes. And the subcutaneous electrodes is again classified into two, that is pericutaneous or implantable electrodes. Now this pericutaneous electrode, so let's see which is good to use and which is not good to use. So each one you can use based on your application and your convenience. Okay, so whether that particular disease or particular nerve is getting that problem is solved, then depending upon that, you can use the required electrode. So in pericutaneous electrode, consists of, percutaneous electrode consists of a thin wire that are inserted through the skin and into the muscular tissue close to the target nerve. Okay, so it consists of a thin wire that are inserted through a skin, through the skin and into the muscular tissue close to the target nerve. And these electrodes typically are intended for use over a short period of time. That is very short period of time. Why? Because they are prone to infection. Okay, so you can only use for over a short period of time and are prone to infection. Whereas if you want to use it permanently, then the only choice is go for implantable electrodes. So the implantable electrodes are permanently implanted in the patient's body. Now, comparing with the surface electrodes, the percutaneous and the implantable electrodes have the stimulation selectivity, which is a desired characteristic of your FES system. That is the stimulation selectivity is very high for your percutaneous or implantable electrodes compared to the surface electrodes. So in surface electrodes, the stimulation selectivity is very less. Okay, so, but the surface electrodes, you can easily place it without any surgical intervention. Whereas in percutaneous and implantable electrodes, they require surgical intervention for their implantation. Okay, so which is a surgical procedure is required for these electrodes, whereas here there's no surgical procedure is required. So they are very easy to place on the location, okay, surface electrodes. Similarly, that you are placing for your ECG machine, the same surface electrodes. Okay, so it's very easy. But the stimulation selectivity is very high for percutaneous or percutaneous and implantable electrodes compared to your surface electrodes. Okay, so that is in short the details about the electrodes. And nowadays in the implantable electrodes, what is happening is that the electrodes integrated with the sensing and the processing into a single, all are packed into a single package. Okay, so that is available in the implantable electrode technology. Okay, so that is the recent one. Now we'll see with an example. Okay, so the example that I'm going to take is drop foot or foot drop is a condition characterized by weakness or paralysis of the muscles involved in lifting the front part of the foot. If you see in this diagram, so this is the normal foot. So you can easily go up and down, you can put it ground, but a person who is having this problem, that is drop foot condition, what is happening is that he won't be able to lift the front part of the foot off the ground. Okay, I repeat, he won't be able to lift the front part of the foot off the ground. So it creates a lot of inconvenience for that subject. So this is the nerve that is associated with that problem, that is peroneal nerve. So when you're placing the electrode should be close to this nerve, okay, for FES system. Now let's see how this FES system solves this problem, okay. Now in foot drop cases, the foot sutures are generally used as the sensor. Okay, so the sensor is nothing but your foot sutures. Now the electrodes may be surface or implanted electrodes to supply the excitatory electric current to the muscles or the nerves within the body. So here the nerve that we are talking is your, the previous diagram we are seeing the nerve, that peroneal nerve is the one where we will be placing the electrodes. So that can be of surface electrodes or implanted electrodes. So the device are commercially available to elevate the foot drop. Okay, so elevate the foot drop. They work by sending low-level electrical pulse to the peroneal nerve, which signals the leg muscles to lift the foot. If you just remember that basic block diagram, I had a sensor unit, which is given to an electrical stimulator, followed by an electrode, followed it is given to the subject. Now here, this electrical stimulator is nothing but your pulse generator, which will produce the low level or generate the low level electrical impulse, which will be applied via your electrode, so which can be surface or implanted. So usually we'll be using surface, that is very convenient to use it. So you'll be using surface electrodes to the peroneal nerve, and which signals the leg muscles to lift the foot, so which will be rectifying the problem. So they work by sending a low level electrical impulse. So this is given from the electrical stimulator to the peroneal nerve, which signals the leg muscles to lift the foot. Now they are single channel foot switch control device that make use of skin surface electrodes placed. So I said mostly we will be using the surface electrodes rather than going for the implanted one, but there is an option, you can go for the implanted electrode also. So implanted electrodes are the advantage is that it is permanently placed, but the problem is that you need a surgical procedure is required. Okay, so they are single channel foot switch control device that make use of skin surface electrodes placed typically over the common peroneal nerve. So this over this nerve only you have to place it. As it passes over the head of the fibula and the motor point of the tibialis anterior. Okay, so whenever you are placing the electrodes, it should be near to this area, that is nerve, that is peroneal nerve. Otherwise, the treatment won't be effective. So the sensor is worn in the shoe. Okay, so the location where the sensor is kept in the shoe. So it's a heel switch which detects the pressure changes as the foot starts to move. Okay, so which detects the pressure changes as the foot starts to move. So this is one way, that is, this is how the FES system is used to solve the problem of your drop foot. Okay. Now let's see another system that uses the FES system. So this is a block diagram of a FES system controlled by electromyographic signal. So now in the figure shows an interactive FES system based on EMG that helps in the recovery of motor function of the upper limbs. So mainly helps in the recovery of the motor function of the upper limbs. So what it does is that here the intensity stimulation or the stimulation intensity depends on the EMG values that you are taking from the forearm region. Okay, the intensity stimulation or the stimulation intensity depends on the EMG values that you are taken from the forearm. So first what it does is that the EMG signal from the forearm region is acquired by using surface electrodes. So here we are using surface electrodes. So by using the surface electrodes, the EMG signal from the forearm region is acquired and it is given to the EMG amplifier for amplifying it. Now, after the EMG signal has been detected, so after the EMG signal has been detected at a certain joint angular reference. So here you can see ankle movement reference is made out. Okay. So that is what it does. So after the EMG signal has been detected at a certain joint angular reference, it is applied to a low pass filter, which will take care of the noise and artifacts. Okay, so the low pass filter is used to reduce the noise, effects of noise, and other artifacts. Okay, so mainly to remove the noise and the artifacts, and then it is given, the signal goes to a controller circuit. So this controller circuit adjust the intensity of the electrical stimulation signal, that is your intensity stimulation or the stimulation intensity. So the controller adjusts the intensity of the electrical stimulation signal based on the magnitude and the frequency of the received EMG signal. Now I repeat, your controller circuit adjusts the intensity of the electrical stimulation signal based on the amplitude and the frequency of the received EMG signal, and the simulator then delivers back or delivers the current to the forearm muscles via surface electrodes. So this is giving back to the forearm muscles through your surface electrodes, and that is how the working of this block diagram. So here your stimulation intensity depends upon the value of the EMG signal that you have acquired. Okay, so that is how it works, and this is by doing this, it will be helping the recovery of the motor function of the upper limbs. Okay, so this area it will be helping, okay, the motor function of your recovery of the motor function of the upper limbs. So this entire thing, the description of the block diagram is given in this slide. So you can go through it, the same thing whatever I said, I have put it in the slide, so you can go through it, the same point. Okay, so and that's it. Okay, so the reference for this slide is, the slide material is, I have referred two books, so you can follow these two books. That's all. Thank you.